You are such a cutie. Yes, you are. You're a cutie. Oh, is it? Oh, it's time? Oh, hi. We got the zoo here with their friends. And Wynn Danielson, I think we're going to count on you because right now you're empty-handed.
Yes.
And Greg Balcom, the director of the zoo, you're real comfortable doing this all the time because you just live with animals, don't you?
We do live with them. And some are just a little bit more squirmy than others.
Now, I got a real friend here. He's ears up is a good sign, right?
Yes. His ears go back as he's uncomfortable.
Because when he's looking at me. Now, okay, what are these animals? Well, look at this. See, now he's at, just relax, right?
You have a juvenile Flemish giant rabbit. So he's still young, so he's got some growing to do. He can get up to 2.5 feet long, 15 pounds. We can trace their lineage back to 16th century Belgium. They're originally bred for fur and meat, but now most people simply keep them as pets.
You're not going to talk about fur and meat in front of him, are you?
He does have big ears. So
okay,
I
now,
don't know.
Now, Greg here, as now you've made a career in animals in the zoo, and it, yeah. But you normally don't have furry armadillos.
No, this is
around.
A screaming hairy armadillo. So very, very unique armadillo species from South America. But we have three different species. Can you hand me that towel, Wynn?
Yes.
We have three different species of armadillo at the zoo.
I hope I don't need a towel.
And they're all, even though they look a little bit similar, they're remarkably different in the way they behave. But this is just one of our newer varieties, not often seen in captivity, and we've had such good success.
For probably good reason.
Yeah. We've had such good success breeding our other species that we're looking forward to breeding this one too.
You know, Greg, I probably need to tell you that Jack Kane has done such a good job handling animals on television. He now has a Saturday morning program on a competing station.
Yeah, I don't think I'll be his competition.
But why do you have these animals? I mean, what's the purpose of them? Because they're not behind a bar and they're not in a case.
Yeah, they're part of our education department. So we have animals that are on exhibit when you go in the zoo and you see them. But we also have animals when we have schools come in and a lot of times for birthday parties and those kinds of things where we can give children an up-close and personal experience of the animals. And it really brings the education up to another level.
Okay, now I thought you had told me that these animals were trained to be with people, but you said he's a juvenile. So is this his first time out?
On TV, yes, it's his first time on TV. But he has been out in classes with
students. Our audio guy is probably going nuts because I think he's over my mic, right? Now, you know, Wynn's being real smug while we're kind of being distracted. But what's in your case there?
I'm just working up courage to get Spike out. This is Spike.
You're going to get him out.
I'm going to get him out, and hopefully I'm not going to pop the top of this, and he's going to go flying because that would be bad for everybody.
Yeah, but the rest of us probably would appreciate that.
He is an emperor scorpion, and who's not cooperating. I have to get behind him is the issue.
You can sense fear.
He was so, did you notice how smug Wynn was
when his
animal was in a cage?
Yes, I need to get behind him is the
okay,
issue.
Okay, now, what happens when a scorpion stings you? I just thought I'd
He's unlikely to sting me. It's more like a bee sting with him. It's not deadly or anything like that, but they use their stinger more for predation. I guess I could pour.
For who?
For predation. They use it to subdue other animals that they want to eat.
Like humans?
No, not like humans. He's more likely to pinch me than he is to sting me. There
That's what you said before you opened the thing.
Yes.
Yeah, but you're acting like you're afraid of him stinging.
Well, that would hurt more. The pincher hurts, but the stinger would hurt a lot more. It's like a bee sting. So, but he comes from the west coast of Africa. They live in tropical rainforest type areas. So, he's about... He'll get to about 2.5 inches long, I think, is about as big as they get. But scorpion species exist worldwide, with the exception of Antarctica. So,
in fact, I think it's kind of a universal animal of fear.
It is. Yeah. I've really just gotten over my fear of scorpions because we acquired some for the education programs, and so I was trained how to handle them.
Plus, you knew Wynn would
try it
handle
first.
It. Okay, we've been having so much fun with these animals. Why are you guys here? What do you want to talk about?
Well, I want to talk about some of the new animals that we have at the zoo, for one thing. Specifically, we have a new baby Siamang, which is a...
Who has been a huge hit.
Mm-hmm. She is amazing to watch every day of the week. She's just really remarkable. And we just had our naming contest. We have our top four names chosen.
And they are?
People can vote for just a couple more days.
Babu, Malaya, Lola, and Simantha.
Okay.
Simantha is my favorite, but the runaway favorite so far with the voting is Lola.
But you'll accept any name that wins.
Oh, absolutely. And the winner, the person who submitted, because initially we had people submit the names on Facebook before we had the voting. And the winner of the name that we select, the person who suggested it, is will win a $200 shopping spree to the zoo gift shop.
Which, by the way, I gotta say, is an awesome gift shop.
Yes, indeed.
It is.
And if it's more than one person suggested the name, then we'll choose the winner at random. So.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Now, we've kind of mentioned that in the next segment, we've got some other unusual guests called Jane and Tarzan.
Mm-hmm.
They do exist, for real, in the Hurrah Players world. But they're going to be at the zoo too, right?
Indeed. We're working with the Hurrah Players. We're going to do a little scavenger hunt at the zoo, Tarzan themed. And that's from February 23rd through March 9th. And people that participate in the scavenger hunt will enter for an opportunity to win free tickets to the show. And also zoo members will get discounted tickets to the show as well.
Cool. I'm going to ask you about the tigers. Where are they?
We sent our young pair of male tigers off. All large cats, most zoo animals actually, are managed by a committee of experts nationally. So they tell us where to send our animals, like our lion cubs, where to send those cubs to meet their perfect genetic match at the next zoo to breed into the future.
Oh, okay.
So we were recommended to receive a young breeding pair, the female of which has just arrived from the Bronx Zoo last week, and the male's coming from San Diego next week. And then our two males we sent to a zoo in Florida. So we're on a roll with breeding big cats at the zoo, and within a couple of years we should have some tiger cubs. They're going to be young animals, our new pair.
But have you discussed this with the tigers? Do they know that this is their purpose?
No, and tigers can be pretty tricky to introduce to each other, so it's going to be a lot of fireworks at the zoo.
Now, in the same exhibit, you've got some orangutans that kind of have a minds of, and I think the last time you were on, you were giving us an uptake, and you were measuring success in second mode.
Right. That was, I think, our record for the female orang being on exhibit outdoors was 20 seconds.
Yes. Yeah, so how is she doing?
They have spent more time outdoors this past
21
fall.
Seconds?
Yeah. And they're on view every day because you can watch them in their playroom. But we're hoping for a big spring where they'll both go out. But both of them did spend a little bit more time out on exhibit.
Now, I heard that you're getting into tough love and taking their blankie away. Is there truth to that rumor?
We do take some of their favorite things and put them outdoors in the big exhibit, so maybe they'll go out and retrieve them. So we do play a little bit of that.
Now, and again, I'm somewhat facetious, but these are still animals that behave as if they're in the wild. So, I mean, you're not training these animals except for healthcare purposes, right?
If you're talking about the education animals that we have here, these are really, you know, our ambassadors create that link between people and wildlife and the environment, so people care more about animals. I think it's the best way to make a point and have people feel that wildlife is important is to meet the real armadillo in this case. But our other animals do go through quite a bit of training just to make them more manageable. Like, we ask our tigers to come over to a certain spot so we can examine them closely without, say, knocking them down with drugs with a veterinarian. So the keepers train them with treats to come here and
I was going to say, how do you
behave.
Invite them over? Just, here, kitty.
They
don't
do that. They use all sorts of various targets and calls for them to respond to.
Okay. Well, you know what? I just got, I think it was the here, kitty that drove them nuts finally. This has been great. Oh, you've put yours back, so I guess it's time to close up the segment and introduce Jane and Tarzan. Stay tuned. Thanks a lot, guys.
Thank you.
Thanks.